Welcome to this brief guide on how to use named ranges in Excel. Creating and managing formulas in Excel can get a little confusing when you are referencing multiple ranges across different tables and sheets of your workbook. Today, I'm going to walk through setting up and using named ranges to help mitigate this confusion and make your formulas easier and faster to create. Here I have a very large table containing some employee data, about 1,000 rows of data, and I have it organized using these categories in the header row. I also have a second sheet in this workbook where I would like to be able to extract a select set of data from the table on the first sheet. Instead of making formulas and constantly needing to go back to reference my original table, I'm going to set up some named ranges. Selecting a cell in my table, we can see the details of the cell in the name box left of the formula bar. Currently, it just shows the cell location, but it can do a lot more than just that, as we will see in a moment. Clicking on the drop-down arrow here, we can see names for both of the formatted tables in my workbook. Most of the tables in your workbook will have a name assigned to them automatically. When I select my employee data table, we can see the name box shows table_employees. But I need to reference individual columns of this table, and so I'm going to make a named range for each column in just a few clicks. The first step is to select the entire table, including the header row at the top. Then we head to the Formulas tab in the ribbon. We then move over to the Defined Name section and select the option for Create from Selection. Selecting this will give us a small pop-up window where we customize where we will get the names from. All of the values that we wish to use are located in the top row of our selected cells, so we will want to ensure that the top row option is selected. Once we have selected our preferences, click OK to confirm. And in no time at all, we have now made 13 more named ranges based on the columns in our table. We can see them all when we now click the drop-down for the name box. Now that we have these ranges set up, how do we make use of them? What's the benefit of doing this? For this, I'll jump back over to the second sheet where we have the other table. I want to make it easy for someone using this after me to extract the data they need simply by updating the name in the full name cell. To start with, I will select this cell and head to the Data tab of the ribbon and open the data validation options. I am looking to make a drop-down list using the list of full names from the raw data. Normally, this would require me to manually input the specific range of cells, but we can now simply use our named range for this. In the source field, I can type in =full_name, and Excel will recognize the named range and automatically reference the correct range. And we can verify this using the drop-down and selecting a name from the list. We can also just begin typing a name into the cell, and Excel will provide options that match based on the data in our list. A named range doesn't have to be multiple cells either. Our cell here, B4, is going to be referenced in all of our formulas, so let's give it a name too. It's as easy as selecting our cell and clicking into the name box. I'm going to call this cell name_search, and clicking enter adds it to our named ranges. Now let's build some formulas using these. To view which names you can reference, head to the Formulas tab of the ribbon and select the Use in Formula option. For our first formula, I'm going to use an XLOOKUP formula. For the lookup value, I want to reference our name search cell. I do this by just typing in name_search, and you can see that Excel is providing the choice to autofill from our named ranges. Use the tab key to complete the highlighted suggestion. And for our lookup array, I don't need to go and find the right cells on sheet 1. I just begin typing in full_name and use the tab key to complete the suggested range again. And same again with the return array, referencing the annual salary range in this case. This formula is much easier to understand at a glance when compared to a bunch of arbitrary cell references. I now have the annual salary done and moving on to the bonus percentage column now. I can use the same formula and simply replace the return array with the bonus range. And the same again for both the job title column and finally with the hire date one as well. And in order to pull data for a different employee, all I need to do is select a different name for the name search cell and all of the other cells update accordingly. And if you ever need to find out what named ranges you have in a workbook, you can head back to the Formulas tab of the ribbon and select the Name Manager option. In the pop-up window, we have all of our named ranges, and we can select any of them and edit their details if needed. Here I want to change the bonus range into bonus underscore percentage instead, so that the name is a little bit more obvious for others. We have a formula referencing this range, and selecting that cell, we can see that the name used in the formula has been updated automatically for us too. And that is how you can make formula creation faster and easier than ever through the power of named ranges. I hope you found this guide extremely valuable and it saves you plenty of time in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.